Hi, this is Sarah with DB Services, and today I'm going to be going over how you can upgrade your FileMaker application with the new upgrade tool. Now let's get started. So I have two FileMaker files here, and while they look the same, they have some slight differences going on in the backend. So for version one, we have two value lists and two scripts. In version two, we have four value lists, so an additional two, and three scripts. And this one has the check mark so that it shows up in the script dropdown. So today we're going to focus on updating this version one so that it includes the new value lists and scripts from version two. Before you can update your FileMaker file, you will need to download the upgrade tool. So I already have it right here. And I'm going to reference it in my terminal, the path to the tool. I'm going to go ahead and run the command to generate the unique identifiers for both files. So it looks like this, generate GUIDs, and then you'll want to put the source path to the file. I'll go ahead and do version one first. Okay, so I have it right here in this folder, and I'm just going to drag and drop it. Oh, and I think about it, you will need to close out of your files before you run this command or any command that uses the source path. Okay, that created a copy of version one. Now let's go ahead and do version two. So just drag and drop. All right. I'm gonna go ahead and place these on the desktop. Not rename them. Let's do a copy of version one. And copy of version two. So once you've done this, you'll need to go into each file. So let's minimize this really quick. So I'm going to go into copy version one, and you'll want to save each file's XML. Let's see here. So I'll go ahead and save that to desktop. And I'll do the same thing, version two. So save a copy as XML. Again, you'll want to do this on all files that you're using. So I'll go ahead and put those over there. All right, so once this is finished, you'll need to create the patch file. So I'm going to include a simple template for the patch file in the download link on my article, but I'm just going to run through it really quick just to get a better idea of what it does. So the patch file is an XML file that contains only the additions that you've made in the updated version of your file. An easy way to find the differences is by using an XML difference tool. So I found one online that's relatively easy to use. The URL is diffchecker.com right here. And so let me just show you how this works. I'm gonna pull up these files. Drag this over here. Okay, so I'm going to copy all of the XML from version one and place it into original text, and the XML from version two I'm going to place into change text, and then click on find difference. Okay, I'm also going to make this a little bit easier to read. Trim out the white space. All right, now, so once it's done loading, you can see the differences I've made are highlighted in green over here. So I've already created the patch file, and I'm just gonna walk through the steps I took to create it. So you want your patch file to begin and end with these tags right here. And you want each new addition to be surrounded by this add action tag. All right, so As you can see here, I've already copied and pasted all the value lists information that I needed from the changed XML. So let me show you where that's at here. Okay. So essentially I just copy and pasted everything in between these custom value tags. And I also grabbed the value list catalog tag along with it. So when I scroll down, I've also already added in my new script, and that included the script catalog tag along with steps for scripts. Both of these are necessary when you are adding new scripts. All right, let's go ahead and get out of this and pull our tool back up. Okay, so from here, you'll want to open up your command line again and make sure to reference the command tool, or the upgrade tool, I should say. There we go. So one thing you can do before you run the update command is you can run the validate patch command. And this command just ensures that your patch file is in the acceptable format for the upgrade tool. So I'll just go ahead and we'll just run that really quick. So validate patch, patch path, and I'm just gonna drag and drop that patch file over here. And it also wants a source path to validate against. So we'll do source path, and I'll just do copy of version 1 and run that command. Okay, patch file validated. That is the return that we wanted. Another one you can use, I'm not going to run it, but it's encrypt patch, patch path. And of course, you know, your patch path goes here. And then you would do patch key and insert a password of your choice. But we're just going to get right into the update. So let's do... It's actually right. Let's do what? This. Okay. And then we do update source path. And for now, I'm just going to use the copy that it spit out because I don't want to make any changes to my original copy just yet. And then we're going to do patch path after that. So let me get that back up. Okay, so once the command has finished running, you should find a new updated copy of your file. All right, and then this should now have 4 value lists, which it does, and 3 scripts, and it does, and it brought over the properties of the script as well. So there you have it, a brief walkthrough of what the new FileMaker app upgrade tool can do. If you have any questions about this feature or any FileMaker needs, please don't hesitate to give us a call.